Hey guys, Scotty here, and we're with Matt Blasco and his 72 Dodge Dart. This thing's a bit of a surprise package. It's flat black, and it's, you know, it's not the prettiest thing, but there's a 572 up front, twin 91 mil comp turbos, all aluminium block, and Matt's come down from Canada.
Yes, sir.
G'day, mate.
Came from Alberta, Canada to drag week to start some racing.
What's it run so far this week?
Around a 770 at 185. We've been really blowing through the converter bad because it's a new combo. Never really figured that we needed to put a more aggressive stator in it. So it's kind of like a snowmobile. It just sits at 7,400 down the track through every shift and doesn't lose RPM. So
it's doing pretty well to run the numbers you're running with those problems.
I used to run a 727 with all the exotic parts, but it, at that 1,000 horse level, and I used to run a few different combos, it was one of those things I kind of like having my legs, so went to a turbo 400. They've been working really well. Yesterday I turned it up out of the hole, and it was just going into second. The wheels were still up in the air, and then the tranny let out. It was the first gear clutch drum hub.
You're running a Mega Squirt 3, I believe.
Yeah, an MS3 Pro from DIY Autotune. It's been working really well. I also run their CAN EGT setup, so then that way I can balance the cylinders, watch it throughout.
You do all your own tuning?
Yeah, I do my own tuning. I run my own chassis dyno service, LA Dyno, for more of a hobby. And it's nice because, you know, you can go through it. The thing actually gets good mileage cruising down the road. And when it's on boost, it seems to always run really well. It's fully sequential. And I'm still using just an MSD crank trigger and a distributor, but I use that for cam sync for sequential injection.
That's awesome.
I've been involved in Mega Squirt for a lot of years, back to even when they were, you know, starting with coding. So they've really came a long way.
Awesome. So you mentioned you've got your own chassis dyno, so you obviously know what it makes the tyres. I think you told me the other day it was 1,970 horsepower at the tyres.
Yeah, I made 1970. Now looking back to that graph that I had, my mile an hour wasn't quite matching up, and that should have maybe been an indication that the converter was slipping a bit, but we just wanted to get down here and make some runs because we were running out of time. It's a completely new combo. Every pass that this thing's ever been down the track has been a drag week right now with this combo. So we've been slowly getting faster, and I'm sure eventually maybe start giving John Ferrone a run for his money or better him, who knows.
There you go. He's coming for us Aussies.